Pad B, also known as Pad 2, is one of the most anticipated systems on Starbase. It's important not only for future launches, but especially after the Massey incident. It could help SpaceX restart Starship testing sooner than expected. So how is this pad going to be built? And can it actually support full Starship testing? Let's talk more in today's episode of NR Studio. SpaceX appears to be moving Starship static fire testing to the orbital launch pad at Pad B due to damage at the Massey site. Recently, a new transport bay similar to the Super Heavy unit was spotted near Pad A, with preparations underway. This is meant to improve safety by separating transport and testing. Do you think this is a good idea? Pad B will continue to support Starship testing and launches as planned. If you saw this area a year or two ago, you wouldn't have believed it could support such a large structure. Back then, it was pretty bare, with only a small test stand and a few fuel tanks. But now, construction has been going full throttle. They started with the tower platform, followed by the full launch tower, fire trench, and orbital launch pad, among other structures. The orbital launch pad was added about halfway through the construction timeline, and now smaller systems are being built to complete the whole thing. One major update is the installation of a manifold system on the orbital launch pad, which will likely connect to the water supply and fire bucket systems. Recently, the anchoring clamps were delivered and installed, meaning the pad is getting closer to being ready. With all of this progress, it appears that Pad B construction is nearly complete. The next steps will likely involve some initial system testing and then full-scale hardware integration. There has been talk of Pad B hosting joint testing with full-scale prototypes like the Super Heavy or Starship boosters. This no longer seems like a guess. It feels like it could actually happen soon. This need arose after the S-36 explosion at the Massey test site, which caused extensive damage to not only the vehicle but also the test stand and other equipment. SpaceX will need time to rebuild the facility, making Pad B a prime choice to get the testing program back on track. Pad B features similar features to the Massey system, but with additional capabilities. Pad B has a fire trench design with double fire buckets, which provides better safety. By directing heat and pressure away from sensitive equipment, the complete operations module OLM system on the B pad, which includes the tower-mounted sump and the thruster's quick disconnect QD system, makes it more flexible. The big question is whether the Starship spacecraft can easily dock with the OLM on the B pad. If it can, testing could begin sooner than expected. Ship 37 is poised to replace Ship 36, which completed its cryogenic testing in May, and is likely to enter the engine installation phase. Testing Ship 37 on the B pad would be beneficial for several reasons. It would provide valuable data and experience for the new pad, and allow Ship 37 to continue its testing. This is important because Ship 37 is part of the V2 series, which has faced some development challenges. Many believe SpaceX will soon move to the V3 series, perhaps starting with Ship 39. Using Ship 37 for initial testing on the B pad minimizes the risk to the new spacecraft. In the meantime, Ship 37 could benefit greatly from testing on the B pad, especially since the original test site, Massey, is currently offline. Pad B could support Starship's development schedule, as it shares the same structure and utility systems as Massey, making the transition easier. If all goes according to plan, Pad B could become a primary location for testing not only Ship 37, but also other Starship and Super Heavy prototypes while Massey is being rebuilt. This would help SpaceX maintain its launch schedule. Additionally, the OLM design on Pad B has changed. It no longer has the traditional 6 fixed legs and support table, and the thruster QD system is now separated into its own structure. These adjustments reflect the shift toward a more modular and maintainable design. Overall, Pad B's structure now resembles a transport bay, simplifying maintenance and operations between launches. With all of these changes, Pad B will play a critical role in the next phase of Starship's development, both for testing and launches. The pad has gone from being a backup pad. It is now a key part of SpaceX's mission to make Starship fully reusable and operational at scale. This significant upgrade promises to improve long-term efficiency compared to the A pad, which is critical to the Starship program. Starship is getting bigger and more powerful. The new version, called version 3, will be between 142 and 150 meters tall. In addition, new engines called Raptor 3 will be added. These engines will be more reliable, easier to maintain, and will aim to increase liftoff power to more than 10,000 tons. To handle this massive change, SpaceX needs to upgrade its infrastructure for future flights. SpaceX plans to launch Starship 25 times next year, and hopes to reach up to 400 launches per year in just 4 years. During busy times, such as launching refueling stations or sending missions to Mars, they want to launch several Starships every day. Super Heavy boosters can be reused every hour, while Starship can be reused every day. To achieve this, a fast turnaround system is needed, and the B-pad is being prepared to support this level of activity. However, the B-pad alone will not be enough to meet demand, so they plan to expand it. The first step will likely be to upgrade Pad A. Observers expect Pad A to be temporarily closed for renovations, including a new fire trench and an updated launch pad modeled after Pad B. These upgrades will help Pad A support more frequent launches. Going forward, two launch pads won't be enough as Starship's mission continues to expand. SpaceX will likely expand the entire Starbase site now that it's been recognized as a city, giving them more freedom to develop the area. They'll likely build an additional pad similar to Pad B. SpaceX is also upgrading the Kennedy Space Center in Florida. They're working on LC-39A, where they've removed the old launch pad for a new fire trench design. Future upgrades will likely include new fire buckets, tank farms, and modem launch pads to match the systems on Pad B. Additionally, SpaceX has taken over SLC-37, a former ULA launch pad, which will likely be upgraded to match the new Pad B design. Florida is expected to have multiple launch pads in the future, which will help SpaceX improve its launch schedule and split missions between locations, especially for NASA's Artemis missions. The Department of Defense is working on a rapid delivery system for packages and people that does more than just launch rockets. This new launch pad will also help achieve an important goal, landing Starship. SpaceX has already shown that they can land and reuse Super Heavy boosters using a system called Mechazilla, but they want to do more than that. They intend to land both parts of Starship, making it the first fully reusable orbital launch vehicle. This would save a lot of money and lead to faster, more reliable, and more flexible access to space. Would you like to see this system develop? If so, let us know in the comments below. Also, please like this video and subscribe to our channel to stay up to date with SpaceX. As SpaceX returns to testing, there are several pressing issues that need to be addressed with Starship. The main one that needs to be fixed is the COPV issue that caused the explosion during the S-36 test. SpaceX will need to review the flight data and debris closely to figure out what went wrong and make the necessary improvements to avoid future issues in testing and launch. In addition to the COPV issue, there are other issues that have not been resolved from previous flights, including payload door failures, propellant leaks leading to loss of control, engine fires, hardware issues, and vibrations in the engine system. All of these issues need to be fixed to make the mission more reliable. The thrusters also need to be fixed. Their ignition and engine protection systems need to be improved to ensure consistent performance and a safe landing. Right now, while cleanup is underway at the launch site, the focus is on getting the hardware ready for Flight 10. The S-37 and B-16 versions are still at the production site for final checks and integration. Pad B is getting more attention during this phase and will be critical for upcoming test milestones. Its advanced features and design are expected to be important, not only now, but also for the future of the Starship program. With these improvements and refinements, SpaceX may soon be on its way to tackling a major challenge when it comes to Starship. Everyone is now watching Pad B to see what happens next. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next episode, and thank you all for your support.